Have you ever seen somebody unicycling? Maybe wondered, how does anybody balance on the thing? Maybe we're like, I got this, and tried it yourself. But if you've ever tried unicycling, you'd probably agree that riding on one wheel doesn't start easy. So how does anyone balance on a unicycle? Well, the simple answer is, you just keep pedaling. I mean, honestly, things in motion tend to stay in the same motion. A scientist named Newton said that if all the forces magically cancel each other, or if there's no forces at all, an object just keeps going. Unfortunately, that's not enough to really answer how someone can unicycle. I mean, forces don't magically cancel each other. The big problem is really gravity. Gravity just pulls us to the ground. It's a force, and forces can change the way we move. This was also realized by Newton. Newton said that all the forces added together say how an object will accelerate. The sum of all the forces is called the net force. And this net force is equal to the object's mass times its acceleration. In short, net force equals mass times acceleration. So let's use that net force equals mass times acceleration to see what makes unicycling so hard. Here's a unicyclist on a uni, and we want to draw all the external or outside forces. Well, we have gravity, right? Gravity pulls downward, so we can just draw an arrow down. Great, we got one force drawn. That's a good start, but something is missing. Right now, the net force is just downward, and so it would simply accelerate or practically free fall downward. What stops this from falling? It's a contact force. There's a contact force between the ground and the unicycle. The ground literally pushes you up. Don't believe me? Try falling. You'll really feel the ground when you land. We call this special contact force a normal force. But voila, looks like our unicyclist is finally balanced. But there's one more significant force that plays a huge role in unicycling. I'll give you a hint. Could somebody unicycle on ice? Not easily. There is another force between the ground and the unicycle, and that's friction. Friction is the force that ultimately helps us to speed up, slow down, and turn. And all those movements are necessary to balance. That's because a unicyclist is an unstable equilibrium. Unstable equilibrium means that if I'm perfectly upright, I'll stay upright. But as soon as I start to tip over, I'm going to fall. One way of moving to keep ourselves from falling is to do something called countersteering. And countersteering is about moving the point of contact with the ground. I need to change where the point of contact is so I can stay upright. Countersteering is really about making turns, which is, for the novice unicyclist, a major challenge. So here's a question. What does a unicyclist have to do to make a turn? Well, when I want to turn, I first actually steer in the opposite direction. Check this out. I'm about to make a sharp left turn. So what I want to do is I first briefly steer to the right. This makes it so I start leaning to the left. Once I'm sufficiently leaning to the left, I can finally complete the turn. Who would say if you want to make a left turn, first steer to the right? But this secret is crucial to balance. In fact, I even countersteer when riding backwards. Let's check out countersteering with a great trick that all unicyclists should learn: bunny hops. Bunny hops are when you stop pedaling forwards and you start bouncing up and down, kind of like a pogo stick. You have to move the point of contact underneath you for each time you land. Well, let's say you want to hop to the right. First, land slightly to the left and then push off to go bounding away. And if you really want to impress your friends, try the bunny hops on the wheel. Same concept. Move the point of contact in the opposite direction so you can move the way you want to go. What if you want to stay in the same place on a unicycle? You want to do the trick called idling. Idling is rocking back and forth with the wheel, so you almost stay in one place. Idling is really like countersteering because it's all about moving the point of contact with the ground. So, what does all this mean? To just simply ride a unicycle, you have to move the point of contact underneath you, left and right, and forwards and backwards. Before you go unicycling away, I want to say always wear a helmet. Helmets increase the time it takes for a collision between you and the ground. More time for a collision means less force, and less force equals happier unicyclist. You will fall if you try unicycling, guaranteed. The trick is to artfully dismount. Be smart, be safe, and just keep pedaling.
Not so close to camera!